The following is a production of CUTV Sports.
Good afternoon and welcome into the Hammermill Center on the campus of Gannon University, playing host today to the PSAC Men's Basketball Championship, brought to you by CUTV on PCN. I'm Zach Proswell. Joining me is Cody Jeanette. And today, Cody, matches up two teams that are very familiar with each other, the IUP Crimson Hawks and the Gannon Golden Knights. But before we get into this matchup today, let's look at the last games between these two teams, starting with IUP.
Well, the last time that IUP played was in the Final Four round against East Stroudsburg, and they took away the victory in that one, 76-60. Three different IUP scorers in that game reached double-digit points. Sean Dyer had 20, Brandon Northley had 17, and Devontae Chance had 15. So good offensive performance all around by the Crimson Hawks, especially considering in the second half, they doubled their shooting percentage from the floor, going from the 34% in the first half to the 69% in the second half. Literally a 50% increase whenever you look at the numbers.
Yeah, you mentioned they won by 16. They were actually down by 7 at halftime, so that offensive performance definitely helped them out. Now looking at Gannon, they are much more known for their defense, unlike IUP is known for their offense. Their defense struggled a little bit yesterday, but they were still able to come away with the win against Kutztown.
Yeah, they really did. Gannon got the 69-56 victory in that one, but again, three different scorers, just like for IUP, reached double-digit points for Gannon. Janeves Tupain had 17, Adam Blazik had 15, and Jabron Smith had 10. And also, one interesting thing to note, Zach, you mentioned Gannon about their defense. They outscored Kutztown 32-18 in the first half in that game. So they only held Kutztown to 18 points. Phenomenal defensive performance by Gannon, and IUP's offense really going to be put to the test here today against that.
Now, when we look at the season series between these two teams, they've played twice, splitting the series, both winning at home. This is the second time at the Hammermill Center. Take us all the way back to the fall semester, Cody, and that first matchup here in Gannon.
Well, the first matchup here at Gannon, Gannon got the 61-56 victory in overtime. That was an overtime thriller, but the more interesting game for me to look at is the second one, whenever IUP got the victory on their home court, 64-54. They only held Adam Blazik to 6 points in that game. Six. One of the top scorers in all of the PSAC held to a single-digit scoring point. So if Adam Blazik is looking for a comeback, now is the time because he's a senior. It's his first ever PSAC championship game and his last home game. It's his time to light it up.
And now quickly before we take a break, we'll look at the PSAC bracket. IUP did not have a first round bye. They were at home against UPJ. And Gannon, they did have that first round bye. And since then, IUP has been up in Erie basically the entire time. Mercer's and here. It's been a crazy bracket.
Yeah, the only two teams that were eliminated were East Stroudsburg and Kutztown. So only teams from the West are remaining. It's the western side of the conference is the only two teams left, Gannon and IUP. It's all up to them to bring the crown back to this conference.
And although, like I said, this really decides the PSAC crown, Cody, it all comes down to NCAA tournament seeding. Both of these teams in play for the region, and it could decide who could host, because West Liberty, they lost yesterday in the Mountain East. So when we come back, we'll have a few more minutes before tip-off, and tip-off will be next here on PCN.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
to the Hammer Mill Center on the campus of Gannon University. We will quickly pause as the national anthem is about to be performed here on center court of the Hammer Mill Center. We'll be back in just a moment.
Pennsylvania State and the Conference Men's Basketball Championship featuring the Crimson Hawks of IUPE and the Golden Knights of Gannon University.
And welcome back after that splendid rendition of the national anthem, Cody. We'll look at the tail of the tape between Gannon, who's on the left side, and the IUP Crimson Hawks, who are on the right.
Well, Gannon definitely has the defense in their favor, just like we mentioned in our open, Zach. About 15 turnovers compared to IUP's 13. So they get the ball on their chances just about as much as IUP does. But the scoring, IUP 75 and a half games compared to 63 and a third for Gannon. So right now, if Gannon knows that IUP's offense can really light up the scoreboard and put out the fire. So that's what they'll have to do. Shut them down if they want to have a chance to win this game. And the Hammermill Center definitely does favor Gannon here. The last 23 games that Gannon has played at the Hammermill Center on their home court, 22-1. They only had one loss in the past 23 games.
And actually, coincidentally, we were here for that, Cody. That was 2 years ago against Slippery Rock in the PSAC quarterfinals. That game went to overtime. We'll look now at the starters for IUP, reading them off. Jeremy Jeffers, Devon Cottrell at forwards, Devontae Chance, player of the year in the West, Sean Dyer, and Brandon Norfleet rounding out the guards. And IUP, besides Devontae Chance, they have a lot of talented players in there, especially Sean Dyer, Cody.
Yeah, especially whenever you take into consideration there were three different shooters in the last game against East Stroudsburg that went into double-digit points, one of them even reaching 20.
And now we'll look at the starters for the Gannon Golden Knights, the one seed in the West. Rafael Thomas Edwards and Adarius Porter will make up the front court. Adam Blazek, Jean-Yves Toupain, and Jabron Smith, the three names that you mentioned in our open, will play the backcourt. And besides Blazek, this team can score when needed, but it's all about defense, and it starts down low with Adarius Porter.
Yeah, getting the rebounds down low is just as important as putting points on the board, especially on the offensive side of the ball. I keep saying this with a lot of broadcasts that we do. Two of my favorite stats in basketball are offensive rebounds and turnovers, because they give a team's offense a second chance to put more points on the board, even a third or a fourth chance if you're going for multiple rebounds in a row.
And both of these teams are very good at rebounding. We saw yesterday both of them establish dominance in the rebounding categories. And Cody, we have just a few more moments to get underway. If you're IUP or Gannon, What do you say to your teams if you're Coach Joe Lombardi or if you're Coach John Riley? What do you tell your team right now knowing this is the biggest game you've played so far this year?
Well, the obvious thing right now that both teams are trying to get in their mind is to not let the adrenaline get so much to you. Sure, adrenaline is a good thing, but it can cause the teams to become nervous, play a little shaky in the early few minutes, but just treat this just as if it's game one of the regular season. Just play your game, do your best. Don't make any small fundamental errors that can put you on the downside of the scoreboard, and you'll be fine, whether you're Gannon or IUP. It's the same for both ways.
Gannon will be in the home golden uniforms, IUP in the visiting black. IUP will be going from left to right on your television screen. Gannon will be going right to left. We are just moments away from tip. Looks like it'll be Devon Cottrell against Rafael Thomas Edwards for the tip. And Cody, we are about ready for PSAC Men's Championship action here on PCN.
The 2015 chapter of the PSAC Championship book is completely blank. The author is picking up his pen right now and he's ready to write. Let's see what happens.
And to start it off, the tip is won by IUP. Devonte Chance controls it and we're underway. Bringing it up is Chance across half court. Chance has it, downloaded Northfleet. His jumper, no good. Rebounded by IUP. Offensive rebound by Jeremy Jeffers.
Early offensive rebound, getting the momentum in their favor early.
And that's one of the ways that IUP was able to come back yesterday against East Stroudsburg, all those offensive rebounds. Chance throws it over to Sean Dyer. He takes a contested three. It's good. Sean Dyer gets the scoring underway.
And 3-0 for the Crimson Hawks, getting their offense on an early roll.
Adam Blazek, the player of the year 2 years ago, controls it, feeds it over to Jean-Yves Toupain. Thomas Edwards to Jerbron Smith, the leading scorer for these Golden Knights. Smith, he's going to take a three of his own, and it's good, and we're all tied back up.
IUP going with a man-to-man defense on that one, but Gannon found their defender slacking off a little bit and took the open shot. It went in.
Chance throws over to Jeremy Jeffers. 3-3, just over a minute in. Chance trying to drive in, has the ball stolen away by Adam Blazek, his fellow backcourt foe. Now Jabron Smith going in. His little floater, no good. Rebounded by IUP, but that's going to be that's Gannon. But that's going to be a travel. Thomas Edwards falling down with the rebound.
It looked like Thomas Edwards tried calling a timeout while he was rolling with that, but the official might not have seen his hands go, but he rolled around with the ball before he could get that signal off, so that's what resulted in the travel.
Chance now controlling it for IUP. Goes over to Cottrell, now gets it back. Under 20 to shoot now. Jeffers thought about a three in the corner, feeds it down low. Cottrell, layup is blocked from behind, but they're gonna call goaltending against Thomas Edwards. It's 5-3 IUP.
Yeah, the dead giveaway for any goaltending call is when the ball hits off of the backboard after it's thrown up and hit by a defender. And you can see as Thomas Edwards reached for that, that's exactly what happened. So that draws the call every time.
And I don't even know if it hit the backboard, but it was like right on the rim and you cannot touch it as it's going down. Gannon with control now down by two, 18:05 to go. Toupain feeds it over to Blazek at the top of the key with 15 to shoot. Blazek to Thomas Edwards. He's going to try and step in. Takes a short free throw jumper. It's no good. Offensive rebound to Toupain. He throws it up, but it hits the backboard and goes out of bounds. Unlucky break there for Gannon.
Yeah, the back of the backboard is out of bounds. So on the it's a good save attempt either way, but just threw it a little too high and it clipped the bottom of the glass.
17 minutes and 40 seconds to go here in the first half. Northfleet controls it now and feeds it over to Sean Dyer, guarded by Adam Blazek. Jeffers now in the corner with it is Northfleet. Northfleet driving in, feeds it out to Jeffers at the top of the key. IUP running this four perimeter set offense. Jeffers in the corner for three. That one's no good. Rebounded by Toupain.
Lots of 3-point shots here getting taken early on by both of these squads.
Blazek to Toupain. Almost had it stolen away. He steps in for a jumper and we're all tied up at five.
And there's another long jumper. Both the 3-pointers and the long jumpers appear to be popular with both of these offenses here today. No drives down the post yet, or not that many anyway.
Northfleet trying to drive inside, and he is stopped by Thomas Edwards. Now feeds it over to Jeffers. Dyer, the graduate student transfer from West Liberty, going inside, guarded by Blazek. He's going to jump, throws it down low to a wide open Jeremy, or excuse me, that's Brandon Norfleet, who's down low for the score. Blazek bringing up about 35 seconds until our first media timeout. To Payne, over to a Darius Porter. Jabron Smith to Blazek, guarded by Brandon Norfleet. To Payne with it. Darius Porter, now Blazek, thought about a three, gonna step around, go inside. Feeds it down low, Darius Porter, a nice feed there from the senior Blazek.
And he was wide open, finding the right guy at the right time. And that was a good time, too, because the shot clock was winding down. There was about 7 or 8 seconds left on it. So Blazek knew he had to get something done.
All tied up here. The next stoppage will be the first media timeout. We'll take a quick commercial break at that time. Chance thought about a three. Now he will take a three. And it is good. Devontae Chance has his first 3 points after starting off slowly yesterday, Cody. Now Smith driving in, but he's going to get called for a travel. And with 15:44 to go, Gannon is up or down 10-7 against IUP. We'll take a quick break here at the Hammermill Center.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to make a wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
And welcome back inside the Hammermill Center. IUP with an early 10-7 lead. IUP with control of the ball. 15:40 to go in the first half. Daddy Ugbede fresh into the game for IUP. Jeffers now with it in the corner. Norfleet down low. Guiding traffic. Gives it over to Jeffers. Loses it, but Ugbede is there to control it. He is in for control, but now he loses it. Adam Blazek has control.
Good steal by Gannon. The 2-1-2 defense pays off.
Blazek finds Tupain in the corner. He takes a three, and we're tied up again at 10.
This is exactly how Gannon's first game, or Final Four game, started out. Question and answer. Anything you can do, I can do better sort of thing. We're seeing the same thing happen here against IUP.
15 minutes to go in the first half, all tied up at 10. Sean Dyer with it. Now to Jeremy Jeffers, and Devontae Chance gets a screen from Jeffers, takes a long three. It's no good. Rebounded by Tupain.
Big defensive rebound by Gannon, especially after getting those 3 points on the board. Now they get another chance.
Blazek to Tupain. Wild pass could have set him up for a catch-and-shoot opportunity. Porter feeds it over to Blazek. Tries to set a screen, but it's not able to. Porter down low, trying to go inside. He's going to be fouled. Daddy Ugbede is going to get the call drawn on him, and Porter's going to go to the line for two shots.
Daddy Ugbede was doing all that he could on that previous attempt. You're going to see here on the replay, just keeping his hands in the air, trying to stay clean, but the official saw that he didn't have his feet set and got bumped into, so that'll draw the foul in favor of Gannon.
Adarius Porter at the line attempting two shots, a senior from Stockbridge, Georgia.
We've eclipsed 5 minutes and 25 seconds in this game, and that's the first foul by either team. Gannon still has zero, IUP now with one.
And Gannon now with a 1 point lead. Gannon, this is actually their first lead of the game at any point. And the second one is missed. It's a jump ball rebound. Possession goes to Gannon, though. Rafael Thomas Edwards, a good job fighting in there for that offensive board.
It's a very favorable possession arrow as they get one free throw attempt, now have a chance to put two or three more up.
Blazek inbounds it to Porter, but it's stolen away by Sean Dyer, so IEP gets the ball anyways. Feeds it over to Chance. Going straight to the hoop. Layup. No good. Rebounded by Porter. Now he loses it. Able to gain it back and give it over to Blazek. Gannon slowing the pace down with 14 minutes and 15 seconds to go. Up by one. Jabron Smith now controls it in the near wing. Down low to Payne. Back against the bucket. Guarded by Dyer. Now he's double teamed by Ugbeda and Dyer. Ball is lost. Blazek controls it. Feeds it out to half court. There's only seven to shoot though. In the corner. Toupain for three. No good. Rebounded by Cornell Yard.
How about that fantastic recovery by Adam Blazek? Throwing it away before he could get called for traveling while he was sliding on the ground.
And that's why he was Athlete of the Year 2 years ago. And he's going up against the Athlete of the Year this year, Devontae Chance, right now on defense. Yard controls it. Now down low, Ugbede, and a layup easily in for the transfer from Drake University.
So now IUP taking the lead back, 12-11. Strap yourself in, folks. You're going to see a back-and-forth game here today.
Yeah, it's a lot more offensive-minded than I think we were both prepared for today, Cody, especially with the defense of Gannon. Thomas Edwards now controls it down low, guarded by Ugbede. His floater misses everything, does not even touch rim, rebounded by Jeremy Jeffers. Chance gets a screen from Jeffers. Now he'll step back. Takes a long two. No good. Rebounded by Thomas Edwards.
Defensive rebounds strong by Gannon here early on.
Blazek thought about a three. Now feeds it to Toupain. Jabron Smith, he's going to take a three. It's good, and Gannon is up by two.
That woke the crowd up. 14-12, though Gannon has the lead back with 12:38 left to go in the half.
Yeah, the Hammermill crowd, they're known for being loud, especially when Gannon's up in front, but this is actually the only lead larger than 1 point Gannon has had so far in this game. Jeffers now controls it for IUP. There's going to be a few subs coming in for the Crimson Hawks at the next stop. Chance with it now, 13 to shoot. Dyer, top of the key, guarded by Blazek. Gets a screen from Ugbede, but it does not work, and now he's trapped in the half court, and a timeout called by IUP.
And that was an effective half-court trap. Two people coming up on the ball, using the half-court line as the extra defender. Had nowhere to go, forced to pick up the ball and call the timeout. So that wastes a timeout for IUP. But on the benefit for them, they still get to have control of it.
And the only bad thing about this, though, is, Cody, IUP will only have 5 seconds to shoot.
Yeah, they only have 5 seconds to shoot, so they're going to have to hurry up and get some of these shots off. As we take a look, in case you are just joining us, some of the offensive chances that we have seen so far. It's been back and forth all game long, and it's been heavily favoring long jump shots. Not too many shots down at the baseline or from the blocks on either side of the paint. It's just been from a long distance, three-point shots, long jumpers. That's what we've primarily seen so far.
And Coach Joe Lombardi wiping off the dry erase board after drawing something up for his team. Into the game now for IUP, Tevin Hanner, Devon Cottrell, and Brandon Norfleet. Chance is out. Yard inbounds it to Dyer with four to shoot. Three, two, one. Gets it off, and it's no good. Rebounded by Jabron Smith, and it's two on two. Smith coming in. Layup is no good, but it's going to be a blocking foul against IUP.
Yeah, that foul is going to go against IUP. That's their second team foul of the game. Gannon still has none. We are going to take a look here on your replay. Looked like that was Brandon Norfleet that didn't have his feet set and impeded the progress of Jabron Smith on his way in.
Jabron Smith at the line attempting two shots on the year, 83.1%. He hits the first and gives Gannon a three-point lead now with 12:02 to go. Smith ready for his second. And that one is good as well. And Gannon has their largest lead of the game at 4 points.
16-12, and we're just under 12 minutes left to go in the half now.
The Hammermill crowd starting to get into it a little bit now, trying to distract the IUP offense. Yard feeds it over to Norfleet. Norfleet step back, long two, hits the rim but misses. Rebounded by Devon Cottrell. And now that's going to be a foul called against Gannon. We'll see who that goes against. This one's going to go against, believe, Tupain. But that's going to be our immediate timeout. 11:42 to go. Gannon up by four.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania. With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference.
And we're back as action's about ready to start up again. Chance going to inbound for IUP. He's just gonna throw it to the backcourt, and there to receive it is Cornell Yard. Norfleet with control of it now, feeds it over to Chance. 25 to shoot still for IUP, 11 and a half to go in the first half. Norfleet controlling it, spinning around the defense. Matthew Dogan into the game for the first time for the Golden Knights.
10 Norfleet on the shot clock now.
Chance for a three. It's good, and IUP back within one.
Back within striking distance. IUP keeping it close.
Dogan with it, feeds it over to Porter. Looks like Tupain was the one to exit for Dogan. Blazek trying to step in, feeds it to Porter. Porter steps in for a jumper. It's good, and Gannon back up by three.
Just good, showing good patience there was Porter, waiting for his perfect opportunity to take that jump shot when the defenders were laying back a little bit, and he had a little bit of room to work with.
Porter now with 5 points in the contest. The leading scorer for both teams right now is Jabron Smith with eight. Norfleet stepping in, feeds it over to Cottrell. Layup, no good, but there will be a foul called against Gannon, and Cottrell will go to the line for two.
And that's going to be the second team foul against Gannon. Very quickly, two fouls in 2 minutes for the Golden Knights. As we take a look at the replay here, you see he might have gotten him on the arm a little bit as he was jumping up for that layup attempt.
And that foul was on Matthew Dogan, number 15. That's his first. And you mentioned before, Cody, both teams have two team fouls. First free throw for Cottrell is good, and it's a two-point game yet again. 10:35 to go. Sean Dyer is going to be checking in for Cornell Yard. Cottrell ready for the second. Up. And that one no good. Rims out. Rebounded by Gannon. So both teams have missed a free throw at the start of this game. Not a lot of trips yet so far. Porter controlling and getting hounded from behind by Norfleet. Blazek controls it, feeds it over to Dogan, who can shoot the three. Smith with it now. And now there's going to be a foul called against IUP. Looks like this one's going on Devontae Chance. That's his first.
Yeah, it's going to be his first personal of the game and IUP's third team foul of the half.
Looking at it, IUP has used a lot more subs in this game so far, Cody. Gannon only one sub so far. Only six players have played in this game. Blazek controlling it now. Gets a screen from Thomas Edwards. Feeds it down low to Dogan. Layup is swatted away by Cottrell. Out of bounds because Thomas Edwards fell into the ball, thought he could keep his feet in, and not able to. It's IUP possession.
Fortunate turn of events for the Crimson Hawks there. Had they let that go out of bounds, Gannon would have had control underneath their own basket, but Thomas Edwards tried going for it before it would go out of bounds to get a quick second chance. So it went out of bounds, and now it's IUP ball.
Cottrell, who just had that block, is out now for Daddy Ukbede. Adds a little bit of height to this IUP lineup playing down low. Devontae Chance now with it, feeds it over to Brendan Norfleet in the near wing. Down low, Ukbede spins around, loses the ball. No travel called, rebounded by Jabron Smith.
Might have been a lucky breakthrough, Betty, not getting called for a travel there, but might have slid his feet a little too much.
Smith from Blazek, jumper is good, and Gannon is up by four.
Gannon taking the lead and extending it, 20-16. IUP took early control, but now we're starting to see a little bit of a momentum shift.
Dyer now with it in the near wing, feeds it over to Hanner. Chance gonna take a three. And that one's good. Devontae Chance has hit a couple big threes in this game already.
Boy, that was impressive. That was from way downtown. Devontae Chance putting 3 points on the board.
Just one of the reasons he was Athlete of the Year this year in the West. We actually saw the East Athlete of the Year, Matt Tobin, yesterday against IUP as well. Thomas Edwards stepping in, feeds it over to Porter. In the corner, Smith for three. It is good. Almost rims out, Cody, but it falls in.
And Rafael Thomas Edwards on that one made that all possible. Weaving his way in between the two defenders, kind of like threading a needle almost. If it weren't for that, there would have been no pass to be made.
Hanner controls it. 8:33 to go in the first half. Chance with it now. Dyer, he's going to take a three. And it's good. So a trifecta of threes in the last two possessions for both these teams.
Again, we're seeing the long jump shots come into control here as we have a timeout.
It's actually going to be an offensive foul against Gannon.
I beg your pardon, thank you.
This one's going against Rafael Thomas Edwards, who's backing his way into the paint area with 8:21 to go. IUP with a bucket could take the lead back.
That extra chance could be pivotal here.
Into the game, Rich Austin for Rafael Thomas Edwards and Jeremy Jeffers for Tevin Hanner. Norfleet feeds it down to Ukbede. He's going to the hoop. Layup is good, and IUP does take back the lead.
So there's that extra chance paying off, getting the 2 points on, and switching the lead back to the Crimson Hawks with 8 minutes left.
Blazek, he has not yet scored in this contest. Austin to Blazek. 7:50 to go. IUP up by one. Blazek takes a three. It's no good. Rims out. Offensive rebound almost collected by Porter, but it comes away. IUP ball. Chance going to step in. Go to the hoop. They're going to say the foul was on the floor. No shot. IUP will keep possession, but first we'll have our third media timeout. 7:41 to go. IUP with an early one-point lead here on PCN.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to Make-A-Wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
And we are back here on PCN, 24-23. The IUP Crimson Hawks lead with 7:41 to go in the first half here at the Hammer Mill Center. It's IUP ball. Ukbede gets the inbounds from Dyer, gives it right back. Dyer to the hoop, loses the ball. It's a 4-on-2 for Gannon. Blazek going to the hoop. His layup no good, but he's fouled by Devontae Chance. And Devontae Chance comes away very angry with his teammates at that last series they had on offense.
Yeah, it looked like Devontae Chance on this one got a little bit on the arm instead of going for the ball on that replay you just saw. So that's the first foul in a while called against IUP. That's their fourth team.
Blazek at the line for two. His first is good, and that's his first point of this contest. He also has four assists. The senior, born and raised here in Erie, PA.
Adam Blazek only took two shot attempts so far, one from the floor and one from beyond the three-point arc. He missed both.
And 7:33 to go here in the first half, all tied up. And now Gannon has the one-point lead again after the foul from Chance. So Devontae Chance with two early fouls. He's going to have to be careful, Cody, not to get into any more trouble. Now ball almost stolen away by Blazek. IEP comes over. Now it's stolen away by Toupain. Feeds it up to Jabron Smith. His layup is good, and Gannon has a three-point lead.
Toupain showing the fancy handiwork right there at center at half court. It was a good behind-the-back dribble to keep control and not get called for an over and back.
Now a chant of defense starting on the far side for the fans. Dyer down low to Daddy Ugbede. 6:55 to go, Gannon up to a three-point lead. Dyer, there's going to be a foul called against Gannon here on the play. It's going on Blazek. That's his first.
And that's going to be the 15th foul for Gannon, as you see on the replay. Blazek committing the foul, and that's going to send IUP to the free throw line for another chance to keep the lead close.
Actually, IP's not going to go to the line because they're not going a shooting foul credit. It's an inbounds play. Norfleet jumper does actually get the friendly roll. It's ready to set it, prepared to jump out because of the way it's bouncing.
So there's the 2 points that keep the lead close. I beg your pardon on that. I thought that was a shooting foul, but that was my mistake. So it gets IP back within one.
6:30 to go in the first half. Blazek to Toupain. Double teamed and hounded, but he's going to get fouled. Looks like Ugbede is going to be the one called for the harm. I believe that's his second.
You see, it looked like Ugbede might have gotten a little too aggressive on the defense, pushing him into the corner more. So now Gannon's going to inbound it underneath their own basket. 6:25 left. Both teams now have five team fouls.
And it's rare that you see Gannon in a tight offensive contest like this, up 27-26. Both teams just shy of 30 points. Blazek, he has 2 points as well as four assists. Feeds over to Toupain. Jabron Smith, a senior from Nassau, Bahamas, takes the three. It's good. Jabron Smith has 16 points already.
16 points with 6 minutes left to go in the first half. This man's on fire right now.
Yeah, sort of like yesterday for East Stroudsburg. Everything started going the way of Wes Grant and Rasheed Moore before IEP shut them down. In the corner, that's Jeffers driving in. Loses the ball, Blazek comes up with it. Blazek trying to weave through traffic. He is stopped by Dyer and feeds it over to the man so far, Jabron Smith. He's going in, tries to throw it behind him. And that's lost and stolen by IEP. Chance going down low. It's blocked out of bounds by Adarius Porter. What a defensive play there by the senior.
Adarius Porter, man, Chance didn't even see him coming. As he was going for that long stretch pass, didn't see the defender off of his blind spot on his left side when he was making the pass, but Porter came out of nowhere on this one. Take a look here. Literally, as he was going for the shot, as Norfleet was going for the shot, he didn't see him coming from anywhere.
And running almost into one of the padding next on the walls over there on the Hammermill Center, the far side, and those garage doors over there actually had the concession stand. It's a very small area on both ends of this court. You have to be careful when you're driving towards the basket if you're going to get hit from behind like that. No foul was called. IUP possession, 35 seconds on the clock.
Yeah, Porter just came out of nowhere on that one. That still baffles me. Wow.
And it looks like Gannon may have called a timeout. They're sending both teams to their respective benches right now with 5:28 to go, Cody. So a little bit of sorting to go on through here. And Cody, of course, today we are part of CUTV, California University Television, and we are proud to continue our partnership with PCN today.
Yeah, you're watching statewide coverage of the 2015 PSAC Men's Basketball Championship. This production is brought to your community by our cable partners across the state, serving more than 10 million Pennsylvanians and 3.3 million homes. Whether on cable or online with PCN Select, PCN is your only source for all things Pennsylvania, including sports. PCN, Pennsylvania's neighborhood.
And I believe, Cody, trying to listen to the press announcer as you were saying that, I believe they may have awarded the ball to Gannon, but it does not look like anybody's going to inbound for it, so I may have heard that wrong. So it looks like it still will be IUP ball with 5:28 to go. They're going to put 30 seconds, I believe, on the shot clock. It only says three at the moment, but
31.
31. Thank you, Cody. Blocked from my view here.
Yeah,
the inbound goes to Norfleet. Step back jumper. It's good. Brandon Norfleet redeeming himself after that last block.
All he needed was that was those 3 seconds, Zach. That's all he needed to get those 2 points on the board.
Blazek going to bring it up for Gannon, who is ahead by two with 5:12 to go in the first half. Smith, who has a game-high 16 points so far, feeds it over to Payne. Around the wing to Blazek. Thomas Edwards. Now Smith. He's going in, feeds it to Blazek. He steps in, jumper running away from it is no good. Rebounded by Thomas Edwards, though, getting away from the defense. Beats it down low. That shot is blocked away, but it's going to be a foul called against IEP. Rich Austin going to go to the line.
Well, that was a nice offensive rebound by Rafael Thomas Edwards here, and just not messing around, getting it back down low to get another shot off. Not using the time management strategy that much with that rebound.
That foul is going to go on Devon Cottrell. That's his first, team sixth. So Gannon effectively is in the single bonus now. Gannon still has one foul to give before IUP is in the bonus. The first shot is good for Rich Austin. That's his first point of the contest. Rich Austin, a redshirt senior from Cleveland, Ohio. Gannon, not a lot of players actually from Pennsylvania on their roster. They go a lot of international flair as well as some of the states that border around Pennsylvania. Rich Austin is one of them. His second is good as well, so it's back to a four-point Gannon lead.
Gannon still maintaining the lead. They have had the lead for quite some time now. But IUP, we saw yesterday, there can be a strong second half team, a force to be reckoned with.
Chance with it now to Norfleet. He's going to step in, feeds it over. Now, Dyer for three. Just no good, just rims out. Devon Cottrell, offensive rebound. Now a jump ball, possession favoring IUP with 4:27 to go.
Those corner three-point shots are not the easiest to make, whether you're on the corner or just on the outside of the wing. And then you see the jump ball. Rafael Thomas Edwards getting one arm in there to try to strip it away.
Inbounds goes to Cottrell. Chance with it, trying to circle around the defense. Going in. His layup, no good, but it's going to be a foul called against Gannon, and Chance will go to the line for two shots. That foul's going to go on Rich Austin.
And both teams now have 16 fouls on the half so far. If you take a look at the foul being committed on the replay here, 16 fouls from both sides. So whoever commits the next one will send their opponent to the single bonus.
Chance on the year, 82.6% at the line. His first is no good. He went 8-for-8 against Mercer's 2 games ago. He missed a couple yesterday, and his first of the game goes off as well.
And Devontae Chance, one of the top leading free throw shooters on this Crimson Hawks squad.
Chance second. It's no good as well. He misses both, and he stays at 9 points. All of those 9 points have come on 3 3-point shots. Blazek going to bring it up. 10 seconds from the final media timeout. To Payne, to Blazek. 15 to shoot. Blazek thought about a three and feeds it over to Smith. Smith takes a contested jumper, and it's good. Jabron Smith has 18 now.
And he was contested by Brandon Norfleet, but Norfleet doing a good job staying off to the side a little bit, not interfering too much to draw the foul, the 17th foul for IUP.
Under 4 minutes, it's 3:40 to be exact to go in the first half. Chance trying to go to the basket. Throws it into the corner. That's Yard with it. Feeds it back out to Norfleet with 13 to shoot. Norfleet trying to set the offense for the Crimson Hawks. Norfleet thought about a three, now steps back. Four to shoot, takes a shot, hits the rim, no good. Rebounded by Thomas Edwards.
Big offensive rebound, or defensive rebound, I beg your pardon, for Gannon, preventing IUP from getting the offensive.
Rich Austin, hook shot is good, and Gannon is up to an 8-point lead, their largest of the day.
That's exactly what I was going to say, Zach. The largest lead of the game is we have a timeout here called by IUP.
And that's with 3:05 to go. I do not believe this will be the media timeout, so we'll keep it right here. And Coach Joe Lombardi, you know what, Cody, they were down 7 against East Shottsburg yesterday at halftime, 33-26. So their offense is scoring more. The defense not doing as good of a job, but they know how to come back. If you're Coach Lombardi, what do you tell your team right now?
Well, if you're Coach Lombardi, I would certainly say that you might be down in this game right now, but as you take a look at some of the highlights here, if you're just joining us, but you may be down, but you saw how well you did against East Stroudsburg in the second half yesterday. You're certainly capable of doing that again, doubling your success rate from the floor, getting those key baskets in when you need them, because sometimes it might seem like one basket's more friendly than the other one is. Completely irrelevant, but that's what it might seem sometimes. So just make sure your players are calm and they're playing fundamental basketball, not making any cheap mistakes, and they'll be okay.
Chance will bring it up with 3 minutes to go, down by 8. Yard has it. Now to Hanner. Chance going to take a 3. No good. Rims out. Rebounded by Tupain. Blazek going to bring it out for the Golden Knights, looking to extend their 8-point lead. Downloaded to Thomas Edwards. His hook. No good. And it's rebounded by Tevin Hanner, and it's fed over to Cornell Yard. 2.5 to go. This pass tipped away and stolen by Rafael Thomas Edwards, looking like a defensive back on a football field.
Just taking that one right as he saw it, in the right place at the right time, snatching the ball like bear on honey.
And Adam Blazek barely getting the ball over before a 10-second violation could have been called. Got it over right as the 25 seconds showed on the shot clock. 2:05 to go in the first half. Austin thought about a jumper. He's going to feed it out to Jabron Smith with 8 to go on the shot clock. Smith to Austin. His jumper is good, and it's a 10-point game.
And IUP's defense laying back a little bit, staying behind the three-point arc on that one. That left him open for a wide-open jumper.
A minute 40 to go in the first half still. Our next stoppage will be the final media timeout. Play has been very consistent in this last few minutes. Yard to Ugbede. Ugbede loses the ball. It's stolen away by Gannon. Jabron Smith coming up with it. He has 18. Looking to make it 20. He goes to the hoop. No good, but he will go to the line for 2 shots. We'll see who the foul's going to be on. Looks like it's going to be on Yard, and that will take us to the final media. A minute 26 to go. Gannon starting to really extend their lead up by 10 on PCN.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to Make-A-Wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
And we are back. Jabron Smith about to go to the line for two shots after the foul by Cornell Yard. Jabron Smith, I actually misspoke before the break code. He already has 20 points as well as four rebounds. He has been the main catalyst for Gannon in this game so far.
And he's looking for more points here.
And he makes it 21 now, Cody. And you pointed out to me, IUP doesn't have any double-digit scores yet so far.
They don't, but the scoring has been very widespread for the Crimson Hawks.
Smith now with 22, and that gives Gannon a 12-point lead with a minute 25 to play in the first half at the Hammer Mill Center. Devontae Chance, he has 9. That's a high for IUP. Now Dyer with it. Dyer going to the hoop. His layup no good, but that's going to be a foul called on Gannon. That one's going to go against Adam Blazek. That is his second.
And that's going to be the seventh team foul for Gannon. So both teams right now are in the single bonus after that previous foul by IUP, which sent Gannon to the line, was their seventh.
And this will be 4-2 because it was a shooting foul. Looks like we're going to see Adam Holm-Weber check in for Gannon in just a moment. He might be coming in for Blazek. The first is good for Dyer, and Blazek will take a seat. Adam Blazek, he only has 2 points, but he has 5 assists, a steal. He's really been doing a lot of work helping his other teammates score.
Yeah, 2 points, and he's missed all of his shot attempts from the floor. 2 from the floor and 1 from beyond the three-point arc.
Dyer ready for his second, trying to make it back to a 10-point game. It is good. Gannon still with a 10-point lead, though, with a minute 6 to go. Holm-Weber into the game for the first time, and I mentioned before they get a lot of international players. He's from Denmark, actually, and he's only a freshman, so a few more years in this program. Now trapped in the corner is Tupane, and he's going to get called for a travel, and IUP's defense really needed that stop.
Yeah, IUP needed something to go in their favor to have a chance at shifting momentum, and a good turnover, a good forcing of a turnover is a good way to do it.
Ugbede and Jeffers are back into the game. Hanner and Yard check out. 52 seconds to go. Chance with the ball. Beats it to Dyer. He's going to step in. He will be fouled. Trying to split between two defenders. He will go to the line for a 1-1. We'll see who the foul is going to go against. Looks like it's going to go against Thomas Edwards.
Rafael Thomas Edwards, we're going to take a look at the replay here. Trying to set up a block along with another Gannon defender, but just squeezed right in between them and bumped into Thomas Edwards a little bit, drawing the foul. That's his second personal of the game, the eighth team for Gannon.
Now checking in for Gannon is number 3, Daniel Kegler. And checking out is Rafael Thomas Edwards because he has 2 fouls and you want to get him a third in the next 45 seconds of action. Coming in for IUP was Devon Cartrell as well as Tevin Hanner for Ubede and Jeffers. Dyer makes the first, so he will get an opportunity for a second. Sean Dyer now, I believe, has 9 points in his contest.
Dyer was the one that scored 20 against East Stroud last round.
The second one is good as well. It's an 8-point game now. Gannon still with the lead, but it's been a 4-0 run for the Crimson Hawks. Kegler having trouble inbounding it, but he's able to get it into Tupane. Holm-Weber with it now. He's trapped at half court, and there's going to be a foul called against IUP. Maybe a questionable call, Cody, because it looked like all three players were really trying to fight for the ball in that instance.
Yeah, IUP going for the half-court trap, just like Gannon did earlier on in this half, but it resulted in the negative end for them, so that sends Gannon to the free throw line. We're going to see Holm-Weber take a few shots.
Holm-Weber, a freshman I mentioned before from Denmark, and this lineup is very senior-laden for Coach John Riley. A lot of these players may be possibly playing their last home game in the Hammermill Center unless Gannon can find a way to host the Atlantic region. But most likely this will be the final time that they step foot inside and hear the maroon and gold fans cheering for him as Weber makes the first.
36 seconds left, so these free throws going into halftime are proving to be crucial here for both of these squads.
Both teams have 18 fouls, still in a single bonus. Weber's second is good as well. He now has 2 points in the game. It's a 10-point lead again for Gannon. There's about a one-second difference between shot and game clock, so IUP cannot hold it for final possession. And remember, at home, for those of you that also don't know, if a shot is made, the clock does not stop in the first half. It will in the second if we are tight towards the end. 12 to shoot. Chance feeds it over to Dyer. 10 on the shot clock. Dyer takes a three. It's good. Sean Dyer with 13. 3 seconds to go. Gannon has a hook. Smith gonna lob it up. Almost goes in, just hits the back rim, Cody.
Off of the back rim, but IUP getting the last shot of the half. Huge momentum shifter going into the locker rooms at halftime. 42-35, now the score.
And we will be right back with a little bit of a halftime show. 42-35, the halftime score. Gannon with a 7-point lead here on PCN.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
Welcome back to the Hammer Mills Center. Gannon with a 7-point halftime lead, 42-35. And Cody, a lot more offense than I definitely expected, as we'll look at some of the highlights from this first half. And a lot of them, you may see some Jabron Smith from Gannon. And on the other side for IUP, they have a lot of buckets as well.
Well, Jabron Smith took complete control of this first half for the Golden Knights. We might have expected to see Adam Blazek take control or Jean-Yves Toupain come out and light up the scoreboard. But no, it's been a lot of Jabron Smith. He had over 20 points in the first half, but IUP has been keeping it extremely close, getting it to the basket whenever they needed it, going down the post, going down the baseline, and heavily favoring the long jump shots, both from 3 points and with the long 2-point shots. So they've been keeping it close in that regard. Gannon's also been favoring those long shots too.
And when you look at Jabron Smith, he is the leading scorer for Gannon on the year, just over 14 points. He's gone far beyond that already, of course, in this game. But IUP, their offense, they did start to come back a little bit towards the end of that half. Actually went on a 7-2 run in about the last minute and a half. And that was capped off by a Sean Dyer three. And it seems like IUP has been really good at hitting those outside shots, Cody. When they go inside, they're having a tough time getting by the front court of Adarius Porter, Rafael Thomas Edwards, Toupain, and Rich Austin.
Yeah, they have been. And those long shots from way outside on the wing or in the corner, those are not the easiest shots to make because you're completely parallel with the basket, throwing with no backboard to assist you. And in order for it to go in, it has to be literally nothing but net whenever it falls through. So those are not easy to make. Kudos to both squads for being able to put those shots up and get them on the board with being able to judge the distances and everything.
And you look at some of the more many highlights that we had. Daniel Kegler there getting after that made shot. And we'll look at some brackets now. We will start with the PSAC men's bracket. We looked at it earlier, Cody. Gannon and IUP, of course, in the final. The winner clinching a spot in the PSAC tournament.
And IUP did not have the first round bye like Gannon did. We kind of hinted at that earlier, but they had to come all the way here from the first round. But Gannon, they got the bye and everything, being their first game against Slippery Rock.
And we'll look at the PSAC women's bracket now. And this one has actually been decided. The California Vulcans, after what has been a very tough year. Of course, you and I have seen a lot of their games. After the unfortunate passing of one of their own, Shanice Clark, they claimed the title over Westchester, 86-70 today. Congrats to the California Vulcans. Very well deserved, and they went through very tough teams, Bloomsburg, Gannon, and Westchester, to be able to claim that title. And we'll move on now to some of the other conferences in the Atlantic region. We'll start with the Mountain East Conference. Their men, a big upset. West Liberty actually was supposed to most likely be the number one seed in the Atlantic region, but they lost. So really that opens up for a possibility maybe Gannon or IUP could take it, Cody.
West Liberty was, at one time, projected to be one of the top teams in the entire country, let alone just in the Mountain East Conference. But then Glenville State getting that huge upset and going into the final against Fairmont State. So Glenville State is on fire right now. They probably are thinking in their heads no one can stop them.
And now we'll look at the Mountain East women's bracket as well. Actually, excuse me, we're not going to look at the women's bracket. We'll go on to the CIAA men now, which ended actually last week, and Livingstone was able to come away with a title there. That's their second straight conference tournament title, and they will be representing the CIAA in the conference tournament as well. But Bowie State actually could possibly be in there as well. Actually, Livingstone beat them in the semifinals of that tournament.
Yeah, and Livingstone getting the big final win against Winston-Salem, a tough game for those two teams. Winston-Salem was the favorite, being 15th ranked, against Livingstone, who was only 25th. So that's the another big upset. We've been seeing upsets in a lot of conferences here.
Yeah, and a lot of upsets. And Cody, that really has not been the theme in this PSAC tournament. It's really been all chalk and paper. IUP, I guess you could say maybe an upset over East Shottsburg, but the West is so much tougher. Not really an upset here. And this one, Gannon, the one seed from the West, they keep going to that tradition.
They are. It's very tough. 42-35. Being the halftime score here.
We will take another break and have more when we come back here on PCN.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
And welcome back to CUTV's presentation of the PSAC Men's Basketball Championship on PCN. And Cody, while we have a little bit of a few more minutes, about seven before the second half starts, we'll look at the PSAC All-Conference teams and awards. And we'll go ahead and start with the Eastern Division first team. A lot of schools represented there. Joe Bell from Mansfield, Corey Blake, Westchester, Dylan Edgar from Shippensburg, Wes Grant, Matt Tobin from East Stroud, and Wally Heppen from Lockhaven.
And you're also taking a look at Matt Tobin for East Stroudsburg, one of the PSAC Athletes of the Year we've been mentioning. And like you said, he was an unorthodox style of getting that award. He was the only one since the year that it was first given out in 1988 to average less than 10 points a game and still win the award. But he gets the plays done. He leads in assists and assist to turnover ratio, so he knows how to make the plays happen.
And now we'll continue on to the Eastern Division second team, and there's going to be a trio of players there from Kutztown: Tyler Brooks, Tynell Fortune, and Josh Johnson. Kevin Larkin, the leading scorer among all freshmen in Division II at just about 18 points a game. Rasheed Moore from East Stroudsburg and Charles Pemberton from Mansfield. And that trio from Kutztown was represented well here yesterday in the Final Four against Gannon.
Yeah, they were. And it's no wonder with the talented athletes like Brooks and Fortune and Johnson. Tynell Fortune, actually the former California Vulcan, having some playing time over at California University of Pennsylvania. Really helped put the team on their back, carry them through all the way to the Final Four. But Gannon was the one that got the last word in that one. But still, kudos to Kutztown and those three players for getting their team that far.
And now we'll continue on to the other division in the PSAC, the West. And Adam Blazek, you see there for Gannon. We're watching him now. Devontae Chance and Jabron Smith. We clearly see why he's on the first team. But then you also have Antonio Butler, A.J. Leahy, and Henri Wade Chapman for Edinburgh.
Yeah, Jabron Smith and Devontae Chance, those two names head-to-head right now for the PSAC title in this game right now that you're watching. Chance, one of the top scorers for the Crimson Hawks, and Smith might not be the name that pops up the most whenever you're talking about scoring for the Golden Knights, but in this game, more than 20 points in just the first half. We still have a whole second half to go, folks. Who knows what'll happen for the scoreboard whenever Jabron Smith continues to put points on the board.
And then you look at the second team, Sean Dyer, who's actually the leading scorer for IUP in this game at 13 points. Richard Smith, a transfer coming in for California, making the second team. Rafael Thomas Edwards also in this game. Ian Vescovi for UPJ. Jarray Williams, the only Mercer's Laker to be represented on these teams. And David Winsor, the only Griffin from Seton Hill.
And Zach, I know, you know as well as I, Richard Smith knows how to make the plays happen, just like Matt Tobin did for the East. Richard Smith was one of those players that you always saw open on the baseline, ready to go for that easy layup or ready for the dunk. He was so much fun to watch, so congrats to him and the rest of the West Division second team for getting that honor. It takes a lot of ability to get there, and they did it.
And now we'll look at some of the individual awards. The freshman of the year in the West was Jamin Mason from Edinburgh, helping the Fighting Scots get back into the playoffs for the first time in a couple of years. A great job by that young man.
Yeah, fantastic to get the Fighting Scots back into the playoff picture.
And then looking out at the East freshman year, Kevin Larkin, I already mentioned, the leading scorer among all freshmen in the entire nation.
And Cheney's one of those tough teams out in the East. They've always been good. It seems like they're always in the talk for the playoff contention when it comes to men's basketball. And if you continue to bring in people like Kevin Larkin, they'll go far.
And then we will look at Defensive Athlete of the Year. And Adarius Porter, we've already seen him out here a couple times. Swanton passes away for Gannon. And he's been tremendous all year defensively, especially cleaning up the rebounds. He has a couple of rebounds already in this game. And moving on to the East as well, we will see Tyler Brooks from Kutztown. I know our good friend Matt Hagee's proud to see that. It went to Daniel Boone High School, our own Stephen Mannering as well. As we continue on throughout the individual awards, the Athlete of the Year, Devontae Chance from IEP Coding. We've seen why so far today.
Yeah, we've been mentioning him a lot. He's able to get those points on the board from beyond the three-point arc or down low if he's going to fight knit and grit for them.
Now the East Athlete of the Year, Matt Tobin, and we mentioned the first player to ever win the award since 1988. That does not average more than 10 points a game, and he only scored 2 points yesterday against IUP, but he had a lot of assists as well. And now we'll look at the Scholar Athlete for men's basketball, and it belongs to IUP Anthony Rocco, a 3.743 GPA in communications media from Northern Cambria. Great job by the young man, showing student definitely comes first. And then looking at the coaches of the year, Gary Manchell from Mercer's and Bernie Driscoll from Kutztown, both of them in the PSAC tournament. Gary Manchell may be playing on with Mercer's if they are able to get in the Atlantic Region tournament as well.
Yeah, and Kutztown was able to make it to the Final Four, led by Bernie Driscoll.
And now we will look at some of the halftime stats from the first half. And Cody, what's the one thing that really stands out to you? I'm looking right now, 11 and 12 free throws for Gannon. That's huge. But looking at everything else, what stands out to you?
Steals. Gannon has taken the ball away from IUP 7 times, while IUP has 7 turnovers. So all 7 of those turnovers came from Gannon steals. Just like you said, Zach, 11 for 12 from beyond the charity stripe. That's incredible to get those key free, literally free points. That's why they call them free throws on the board. So 11 of Gannon's points came from there. But the rebounds and the turnovers themselves are pretty even. But the steals, big differential. IUP not stealing the ball as much as Gannon, so Gannon has a lot more offensive opportunity than the Crimson Hawks do.
And IUP, 6 of 9 in three-pointers. That's really how they're staying in this game. Half of their made shots have been from distance, Cody, and 3 of them coming from Devontae Chance. How can IUP improve their shooting ability? Because they've had struggles down low, it seems.
Well, we saw in the second half of the game when they played East Stroudsburg, they really lit up the board in the second half, doubling their success rate from the floor. So if you can just find the flaws in the defense, execute them really well, and you'll be able to get the easy shots. Like we saw, IUP's defense was kind of laying back a little bit against Gannon's, and that left them open for wide open for the easy jump shots. So maybe the tables will turn for IUP if they can find some of the defensive flaws.
And we will take one final break before we have the second half action here on PCN.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
And we are back. The second half just about to get underway. Gannon with a 42-35 lead here on PCN. If you're just joining us, everything was really offensive in the first half. Let's see how it goes in this one, Cody. Adam Blazer with control for the Golden Knights. Now going left to right on your television screen. IUP going right to left. Smith with it. Feeds it to Tupain in the corner. Now down low to Thomas Edwards. Thomas Edwards going around. Loses the ball. Devon Control is able to find it, and that's a steal for IUP.
Rafael Thomas Edwards didn't see the defender coming out of his left side. He looked to his right toward the basket, didn't see him swatted away at all.
Chance passes over to Dyer, who has a team-high 13 points for the Crimson Hawks. Norfleet now within the far wing. Jeffers thought about a three, and now feeds it back over to Norfleet, who gives it to Dyer. 10 to shoot for IUP. Dyer gets a screen from Control. Feeds it to Control now. Trying to find Jeffers. Now he's stuck. And it's stolen away, actually. I was ready to say it's going to Jeffers, but Adarius Porter right there, and we're seeing why he's Defensive Athlete of the Year.
Yeah, getting those steals right away. Gannon with another steal to add to their list.
Now Smith with it. Feeds it to Adarius Porter. Tupain, a junior from Dakar, Senegal, has it. Blazek stepping in. Going to the hoop. Feeds over to Porter. Thought about taking a jumper. He was open for it, but hesitates and passes that to Smith. Five to shoot for Gannon. Smith puts up a shot. No good. Rebounded by IUP. Norfleet throws over to Chance in the corner. Jeremy Jeffers, 4-3. Off the front of the rim. No good. Rebounded by Tupain.
So far, the IUP offense still has yet to find that second half spark that they're so well known for.
Tupain now with it. About 2 minutes in, both teams still scoreless in the second half. Blazek with it, guarded by Devonte Chance. The two players of the year in this building going against each other right now on defense. Now Smith trying to drive in, and that's going to be a foul called against Brandon Norfleet, it looks like. And it could have easily been a charge called against Jabron Smith, throwing his shoulder down and trying to drive in.
Yeah, it didn't look like Brandon Norfleet didn't really have his feet set yet. And because of the rule, you have to have your feet set as a defender for a couple seconds before you can legally defend with body-on-body contact. So that draws the foul, and that's the first foul of the half by either team. IUP has one, Gannon has zero.
17:55 to go here in the second half, and you see one of the child volunteers here at Gannon doing a good job there, out sweeping the court. And they actually have the old Elite Eight logo from last year when the women's Elite Eight was here at Erie. And that was actually across the street in the Erie Insurance Arena. Blazek controls it, feeds it over to Tupain. Thomas Edwards, his hook, no good, rims out, rebounded by Daddy Ubede, who feeds it up to Chance. Dyer with it now, right in front of the IUP bench.
And that was Ubede's first rebound of the game. In the first half, he didn't have any.
And that's very big for Gannon. It shows that you're cleaning up the rebounds really well. Zubedi is a very tall player, about 6'8" or so. Chance, 10 to shoot. Faces to Dyer, thought about a three, steps in. His shot is good. They're going to count it and the foul as well. Good continuation play there by the refs. See, the foul goes on, but that's a 5-point game.
5-point game, and IUP has another chance to cut into this lead. 17-13 left. We're going to see a couple free throw attempts here being made by Dyer. Dyer in the first half, 4-for-4, perfect 100%.
And it'll actually only be one attempt because they are giving him the continuation from the shot. That last foul was on Jabron Smith, his second. The free throw, no good, rims out. Rebounded by Smith, and now it's a jump ball situation, and it goes to IUP. That's a big jump ball call there, Cody. Looked like Norfleet actually even had possession of it, trying to call timeout on the court.
So now IUP is going to get a second chance here on the inbound.
IUP with a fresh shot clock, 35 seconds, 17-10 to go in the second half. Norfleet, inbound jumper, no good, misses everything. Gets the own rebound, though. Feeds it down low to Ugbede. It's good, and the foul. And just like that, IUP finds themselves down by three.
And Norfleet, before he passed it to Ugbede, looked like a pinball in a pinball machine, bouncing off all the defenders, weaving his way through the paint to get that pass to Ugbede. Fantastic ball control by Norfleet to find Ugbede and make the shot.
Thomas Edwards is committing the foul. He will check out for Rich Austin. Ugbede at the line, trying to make it a 2-point game. And just like yesterday, when IEP was down by 7 at halftime, they come out storming an offense, and it is a 2-point game, 42-40.
17:05 left. And real quickly in this game, Gannon has two team fouls already, IEP with one.
And now we can hear chants of defense from some of the IEP fans that are around us over where we're broadcasting at. Jerron Smith feeds it out to Payne. His three from the corner. Misses everything. Just a little too strong. Rebounded by Norfleet. IUP can tie it or take the lead on this possession.
IUP's bench is really starting to get pumped up, and their fans are right behind them. On your TV screen, IUP's bench is on the left side, closest to the near side.
Chance with the ball. Feeds it to Dyer. His three for the lead. No good. Just rims out. And there's going to be a foul against IUP on the loose ball. This one's going against Ugbede. I believe that is his third foul.
And that might have been the break that Gannon was looking for, because IUP had complete control in that previous sequence, and they needed something to go their way, and here it comes in the form of a foul against IUP. So now they're going to get to take their time inbounding the ball and bringing it back up court.
Ugbede sits now with three fouls. Devon Cottrell back in the game. Ugbede also has 7 points in the contest. Smith within the far wing. About 10 seconds until our next media timeout. Back to the basket. Porter loses it. Feeds it out to Smith. Smith stepping in. His wild jumper is blocked. Porter gets the rebound. Shot clock does not reset, though. Porter's layup, no good, but he will be fouled. Looks like this one's going against Cottrell, and it will. But first, we'll have our media timeout. 15:58 to go here on PCN.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to Make-A-Wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
And we are back here on PCN, and Cody, we're watching some basketball here today, but PCN actually has some more basketball coming up in a couple weeks.
They do. Basketball returns to PCN in 2 weeks. You can watch the 2015 PIAA State Basketball Championships live on March 20th and 21st. For team listings and times, visit PCNTV.com. PCN, Pennsylvania's neighborhood.
Now, Adarius Porter at the line shooting two free throws. That last foul was on Cottrell. And Porter's first free throw is good, making it a three-point lead. An interesting thing about Adarius Porter, he's actually from my neck of the woods down in Georgia. Stockbridge, Georgia, actually went to Woodland High School. I actually know where that's at. It's about maybe an hour and a half away from where I'm from.
And that's Adarius Porter's sixth point of the game, going for his seventh right now, and missed.
But his offensive rebound by Rich Austin, able to clean up from behind the front court of IUP. This is a big possession for Gannon. If they're able to hit a shot, it's easily a two-possession game yet again. Blazik to Porter. Thought about a jumper. Now he thought about it again. Now he'll dribble. Back to Cottrell. His hook. No good, but he'll be fouled again by Cottrell. And just like that, Cottrell has two fouls in about the last 20 seconds of play.
Two fouls very quickly, and that hurts because that sends IUP to four team fouls now on the half. Gannon still only has two. They were tied at two in terms of team fouls when we came back from our commercial break. Literally, it was that quick.
Adarius Porter, his first, no good, hits off the front of the rim, 15:36 to go, stays a three-point game. And Daddy Ugbede checking back in, he has three fouls himself. So IUP, their front court, starting to find themselves in a little bit of foul trouble, Cody, and that's an interesting development as the game goes on. Adarius Porter's second is good, and it's a four-point lead for Gannon. Devontae Chance bringing it up. IUP has outscored Gannon by 3 points in this half so far. He's over to Tevin Hanner to Norfleet in traffic. Norfleet steps back for the free throw line jumper, misses everything and goes out of bounds.
And it's going to go towards, it's going to go in Gannon's favor here. Good job, Adam Blazik, not going for the rebound. Not going for the rebound on that one, because if he would have touched it and it would have still gone out of bounds, IUP would have gotten a second chance.
And that shot from Norfleet drew the air ball chant from some of the Gannon faithful. 44-40, still to score. Blazik for three. It's good, and just like that, it's a seven-point game.
And here comes the Hammermill crowd, very famous for getting loud whenever the Gannon Golden Knights score 47-40.
And the Hammermill crowd, if they can get into it again. We mentioned before in the first half how it affected Gannon. Seems they fed off that crowd. Trying to hold IUP at bay, up by seven with 14:40 to go. Ugbede going to the hoop. His layup, no good. That's Porter with the rebound. Blazik bringing it up, and Coach Joe Lombardi for IUP not happy with no foul call there. Blazik's layup, no good. Austin offensive rebound.
Big offensive rebound by Gannon, getting that second chance and resetting the shot clock.
Smith, he has 22, feeds it to Payne. Porter to Blazik. Smith again, now down to Porter at the paint. His jumper, no good, rebounded by Devontae Chance. Now Chance trying to split two defenders. He will draw a foul from Gannon. Looks like this one's going against Jabron Smith.
Yeah, the foul's going to be against Jabron Smith here as he was right at the foul line, reaching in for the ball. You're going to see right there as IUP was charging down the court with it. Devontae Chance trying to make something happen, but Smith wouldn't let him have it, and he drew the foul.
Norfleet to the bench for IUP. We're going to see Dyer check back in. Now Smith will check out. Matthew Dogan in the game, and Jabron Smith now has three fouls as well. So some of the big names for both of these teams starting to get into foul trouble, Cody.
Three team fouls on the half for Gannon, four for IUP still.
Dyer looking for an inbound, so it's a chance. His three from the corner, No good. Misses everything. Ugbete gets the rebound and throws it out to Dyer. The shot clock did reset, though, so it looks like it must have touched the rim. Dyer stepping in. His shot no good. That's going to be a foul called against Adarius Porter. That'll send Dyer to the line for two.
Yeah, Adarius Porter with another foul for Gannon. So now they're evenly matched with team fouls, four apiece, with 13:40 left to go in the half. So both these teams right now need to be careful and not give the other team the competitive advantage of going into the single or double bonus when the end of the game comes.
And they're actually calling this foul against Adam Blazek, not Adarius Porter. So that puts Blazek now with three fouls. And although he's not scored a whole lot for Gannon today, he's arguably their best player. And in his first conference championship game, I'm sure he would not want to go out fouling out. The first shot for Dyer falls in. We're going to see Adam Holm-Weber check in for Blazek now. Blazek probably going to spend at least a few to maybe 5 minutes on that bench for John Riley.
Yeah, the coach for Gannon is saving him for when the time is crucial.
Dyer's second is good as well, and it's a five-point game. IEP still down. Inbound goes to Dogan. It looks like IEP's running the full court press now.
Interesting changeup on defense here.
Dogan gets it across court to Adam Holm-Weber. In a corner to Payne has it. He was open, but elects not to take a shot. 13:25 to go still in the second half. Dogan in the corner now. Weber to Payne. And trying to go down low, but that's going to be a kick ball violation against Cornell Yard III for IEP.
So the clock will stop with 13:12 left. They put 15 seconds back on the shot clock for Gannon to work with. It was winding down to the single digits whenever that kickball was called.
Austin was open beyond the three-point line, and I saw him take a look at it, but he's not a three-point shooter, so he elects not to take the shot. Dogan now with it. He steps in. His layup is good, and the foul against IUP. That's going to count going to the line for and one.
Those were a hard 2 points for Dogan to get. Just driving down the left post and drawing the foul against IUP, being quick enough so that the defender couldn't set his feet and throw the shot up while it still counts. And now Gannon with 2 points added on to their lead.
And that foul goes against Daddy Ugbete. And I was watching the replay as you were speaking, Cody, and he did just get there a little late. And now the free throw goes out of bounds after the miss against Gannon's IUP ball. But Ugbete was there a little late, and he's on the bench now. Actually, no, they have not taken him out of the game. I saw Lombardi looking maybe for a sub, but he elects not to. So Ugbete will stay out there with those four fouls.
Yeah, he has four personal fouls. One more, and he's done.
Hanner with it. Feeds it out to Chance. Chance going to take a three. It's good. Devontae Chance makes it a four-point game, excuse me.
Devontae Chance trying to motivate his team and lead them forward to get back into this game. He did that against East Stroudsburg, so he can easily do that here.
Chance now has 12 points. All four of his shots made today have been from beyond the arc. Holm-Weber, he has 2 points to Dogan now. Down low, Austin Hook is good. It's a six-point lead.
Austin Hook with the hook shot, 51-45.
Now, Devontae Chance bringing it up. The Hammer Mill crowd starting to get up and get loud. The Gannon bench is starting to cheer them on, as you see on your screen right there. IUP needs a score in this possession. Even though there's a lot of time left, they need to keep capitalizing on offense. Hanner, he's going to step in, spins around. Layup, no good, but there's going to be a foul against Gannon. This one's going to go against Rich Austin, and that will bring us to our second media timeout, 11:49 to go. Gannon up by six here on PCN.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about. as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to Make-A-Wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
And we are back here at the Hammer Mill Center. Tevin Hanner going to the line for two shots. It's a 6-point lead for Gannon now, 11:49 to go in this contest. The first is good, and Cody, this has been such a good game already. I hardly know what to expect as this game goes on.
Yeah, it really has been, and if you want to relive it, you can relive the action with a DVD or digital download from PCN Store. Visit the PCN Store online at pcnstore.com to order your copy of the 2015 PSAC Men's Basketball Championship today. PCN, Pennsylvania's neighborhood.
And Hannah made both, so it's a 4-point game yet again. Weber with control of the ball, but he's heavily guarded by Yard. Feeds it over to Dogan. Now to Payne with it. To Weber. Dogan thought about a three. Down low now, that is Porter with it. Porter backing down Cottrell. His layup is good. Back to a 6-point lead.
Back to a 6-point lead for the Golden Knights, looking for things to shift towards them in their favor in terms of momentum, and they're finding it with these key shots being made when they matter.
Chance bringing up for IUP, looking to respond and keep it within at least two possessions. Chance guarded by Dogan, gets a screen. Trying to go around, and Dogan will foul him on his way, trying to drive inside. That is now 6 fouls on Gannon.
Looked like Dogan might have been trying to go for a pick a little bit as he was crossing the paint, but just reached in a little bit too much. And that's what drew the foul.
IEP with a fresh shot clock now, 10:54 to go in the game. To Cottrell, Chance. Step back, thought about a three. Now he'll drive inside, right in the baseline. Layup is swatted out of bounds by Gannon.
And that one was swatted away by Tupain. Tupain leaping up like he was on a trampoline from behind him to swat that ball away and not get called for goaltending. Swatted it away early enough for it to count. But IUP is going to get a retry.
IUP will still have 28 seconds to work with on this offensive possession. Inbounds goes to Hanner, who then feeds it over to Chance. Norfleet with it now in the far wing. Norfleet going in, his floater, no good. Offensive rebound, Cottrell, his layup, no good. He will go to the line for two shots though.
Yeah, Cottrell on that second chance drew a foul. It's hard to tell who it might have been against because there were a couple Gannon defenders reaching in on his arms, but he'll go to the line.
And they're calling that one an Adam Holm Weber, but it didn't even look like Weber was really even contacting him. It looked like Austin was really getting the most contact down there for Gannon. And the first free throw falls in. It's back to a 5-point lead. Cottrell ready for a second with 10:32 to go. And that one is good as well. And it's back to a 4-point lead. And also, that last foul puts IUP in the bonus now. Dogan passes it back to Tupain. Now Dogan brings it across the half-court line.
The full-court press here, putting the pressure on the Golden Knights.
Dogan controls at the top of the key, guarded by Dyer, feeds over to Payne. Porter to Weber. Weber feeds it to Dogan, 8 to shoot. Dogan down low, Porter, his jumper, no good. Rebounded by Devontae Chance, under 10 to go. Dyer coming up quickly. Nice move there. Layup, no good, but he'll go to the line for two. Looks like that foul's going to go on Jean-Yves Toupain.
Yeah, that's going to be the eighth team foul by the Golden Knights. So IUP definitely has that competitive advantage with the 9 minutes and 53 seconds remaining in this game, that any foul, any mistake that Gannon commits, they automatically get an offensive opportunity to score, whether it be from a free throw or from an inbound.
Dyer, currently right now, he has 17 points. Makes it 18 with that free throw make. It is a 3-point game. Smith and Blazek are back in. Doken and Weber out for Gannon.
Adam Blazek with those three fouls coming back onto the court. Head coach John Riley knows that now's the time to put points on the board.
Dyer's free throw no good. Out of bounds off of IUP. Norfleet the last one to touch it. Austin and Adarius Porter were down there as well.
Yeah, Norfleet had to jump over two Gannon players to try to get to that one. A little bit of a desperation attempt to try and save it maybe, but he swatted it out of bounds instead.
Blazek gets across the half-court line, and now a kick ball violation called against Sean Dyer. It will be Gannon ball, 9:42 to go.
27 on the shot clock still to work with for the Golden Knights.
And IUP still has one foul to give before Gannon is in the bonus with 9 minutes and 40 seconds left to go here in this game. Smith, spin around, loses the ball. It's stolen away by Devontae Chance.
Devontae Chance is stealing that away as he was trying to go for the spin move to try to get around him, but Chance read that like a book and swatted it away.
Norfleet feeds it to Chance, guarded by Smith. Screen from Cottrell. Three ball from Chance. It's good. Devontae Chance ties it up.
We're all tied up at 53. Gannon's momentum has completely shifted over to IUP right now.
Porter down low. Feeds it to Austin. His hook is good. And it's back to a Gannon lead, 55-53.
Hook shot giving Gannon the lead right back. Again, question and answer. That's a theme that I've always liked to present between these two squads. That's what the whole game has been like.
About 40 seconds to our next media timeout. IEP looking to respond to Gannon taking the lead back. Chance to Dyer. 13 to work with for IEP. Chance going against Jabron Smith. Gets a screen, now guarded by Porter. Turns around, feeds it over to Norfleet. Norfleet, long two, no good. Offensive rebound by Hanner, loses the ball. Now he's on the court. Austin has it. Timeout called by Gannon. A veteran move there by Rich Austin.
And Gannon on that previous sequence tried going for the half court trap, but the problem was that left Norfleet wide open over on the far side, and he was able to get a shot off as a result of it.
And looking at this game, Cody, we'll actually look at our social media right now. We'll see the CUTV Twitter, at CUTV_PA. You can follow us. It looks like we're still going to be following the California women as they advance to the Atlantic Regionals next week. So you can find out times and air dates of those games. And you'll also have Facebook, Cody, where you can follow us and see where we're going and stuff as well.
Yeah, the California University Television Facebook page, a great way for the alumni, current students, as well as the Vulcan fans or the basketball fans of the PSAC to stay connected. We follow the PSAC tournament down to the wire and also on the YouTube page where all of the California University Television broadcasts get uploaded onto YouTube.com/CUTV Sports 1. Take a look at the sports shoots in their entirety, as well as your one-stop shop literally for all of the PSAC sports information that you may need, from track and field to basketball to baseball to lacrosse. PSACsports.org is your way to go for Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference information.
And you see right there a young lady for rooting, we don't, not knowing for sure, but she was here at the game yesterday, so we actually saw her, and she's become quite a sight to see. A little dancing girl, always having fun here.
Might be,
and Cody,
might be a future athlete there.
Maybe. And besides our social media, we also have the PCN social media platforms as well that you can interact with them.
Yes, definitely. Do you like watching your favorite sports on PCN? Become a Facebook fan at facebook.com/PCNTV, or you can tweet them at PCNTV.
And I know myself, actually, when tweeting out sometimes about doing these shoots, I'll actually get a retweet from PCN, so it's always nice to see that our friends at PCN are connecting with us as well on RCUTV Twitter. And now a 10-second violation called against Gannon. It's almost happened a couple times as game code. I've been watching the clock every time Gannon gets the ball. And that time, just a careless mistake with 8:03 to go.
And that one is going to be crucial. That's a crucial turnover right there for the Golden Knights, because that one can easily be prevented getting across half court within 10 seconds. So now IUP getting the chance to tie the game up or take the lead.
Under 8 minutes, so our next stop will be our third media timeout. Dyer taking a corner three. It's good, and IUP takes, I believe, their first lead of this game. And actually, no, they're calling this a two instead of a three. And now a foul against Gannon as Jabron Smith pushed off Sean Dyer. Everything going IUP's way. They are tied right now with Gannon as we head to break. 7:43 to go, and what turning into an instant classic here at the Hammermill Center.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
The action behind the scenes and under the hood, perspectively.
Now Ugbede feeds it to Devontae Chance. This comes after Jabron Smith's fourth foul after pushing away Sean Dyer on an inbounds play. IUP with a chance to take the lead. Jeffers driving in, feeds it out to Chance. Thought about a three, but he will bring it back, guarded by Porter. A mismatch for him. 10 to shoot. Chance, nice move around Porter. His jumper, no good. Rebounded, though, by Brandon Norfleet. And he'll bring it back out. IUP with about three or four consecutive possessions right now, Cody.
Huge offensive rebound there for IUP, getting the second and third chances. That's why I always say I like the offensive rebounds, because it maintains offensive control.
Ugbede controlling it. Going to the basket. His layup, no good. Rebounded by Thomas Edwards. And now Blazek with it. 6:45 to go in the contest. All tied up at 55. Gannon with 19 fouls. IUP was still one to give before Gannon is in the bonus.
It's been a while since IUP committed a foul, actually.
And Gannon has committed quite a few in a row. Blazek going in. Carries it. Little floater. No good. And it's rebounded by Ugbede. Now Chance going to the hoop. Layup. No good. We're going to call a foul on the shot, though. Looks like this one's going against, believe that's two Payne. That'll be two shots coming for Devontae Chance, and IUP's in the double bonus now.
And so far, Devontae Chance on the day, 0-for-2 from the charity stripe. Still has yet to make his first free throw attempt after that stellar 8-for-8 performance against Mercyhurst in the quarterfinal round.
The first is good, so now he stands 1-for-3 at the stripe, and it's a 1-point lead for the Crimson Hawks. Smith checks out for Dogan. Devontae Chance, the PSAC West Athlete of the Year, with his second attempt, is good as well. And IUP has their largest lead of this half at 2 points, Cody.
Yes, they do. But the question is, can they hang on to it? Because Gannon has had a couple things go their way in the recent time span. So we'll see what happens.
And Gannon, you know, they have that home advantage, but like you mentioned earlier, Gannon has only lost one home playoff game in their last 23 attempts. Blazek going to the hoop. Shot, no good, but he'll go to the line for two free throw opportunities. That foul going to go on Hanner.
That's going to be his second personal of the game, and now this sends IUP into the double bonus. That's Gannon's 10th team foul. Or I beg your pardon, that's IUP's 16th foul, I'm sorry. The last foul committed was the 10th one by Gannon.
The first free throw for Blazek is no good. Surprising there. Blazek on the year, one of the best that Gannon has at the free throw stripe, 83.5%. Blazek trying to make it a one-point game with 6 minutes and a second left. He converts the second, and he now has 6 points.
57-56, we're back to a one-point game.
Under six to go, Chance bringing it up. Norfleet, guarded by Thomas Edwards, throws it to Chance. Jeffers in the corner. Jukes around and moves it back to Chance. Chance. Almost committed a walk. The Gannon fans won it, but looks like he kept his foot there. And now a foul called on Rafael Thomas Edwards will send Daddy Ubede to the line for two shots.
Daddy Ubede still playing really good basketball for having those four personal fouls against him. And this is going to be Rafael Thomas Edwards' fourth personal foul, speaking of those. So that is the Gannon still send IUP into the double bonus. So they stopped keeping track on the scoreboard here after 10, but that make that the 11th.
Ubede's first free throw is good. It gives IUP a two-point lead yet again. Chance to make it three. Hanner is checking in for Jeremy Jeffers now for the Crimson Hawks with 5:38 left. Ubede ready for his second. And that one is good as well. Ubede nearing himself into double figures, and he actually has. He now has 10 points in this contest. Blazek breaks the full court press easily, and now a foul called against IUP after Blazek gives him the shoulder. That one's going on Tevin Hanner. And Blazek will go to line for a 1-1.
Yeah, Blazek's shot doesn't count, but the foul committed was the 17th foul by IUP, so that's what sends Blazek to the free throw line. Blazek so far in the game is 2-for-2 from the charity stripe.
And actually, we have to include his last miss from our last stat update, Cody, because he's now 3-for-4, because he missed the first of two shots his last time.
You're right, Zach.
Thanks. His first is good, makes it a two-point game in favor of the IUP Crimson Hawks. Blazek, senior from Erie Cathedral Prep, right here in Erie. He was born and raised here and came to the school, maybe even right down the street from the school. I'm not even sure where Cathedral Prep is located, but he makes both and brings it to a one-point game, 5.5 left. Now the Hammermill crowd trying to chant defense yet again, and that's where Gannon is most known for, is their defense. But Dyer trying to break it, puts up the layup, and he does. Three-point game.
And he was contested there by both Blazek and Porter, putting their arms in the air, but just able to push them away just enough to get a clean layup in there. 61-58 now.
And Coach Lombardi is telling IEP, no more of the full court press. Go back and play defense man-to-man on the backside. It actually looks like a 1-2-2 zone. Blazek for three. It's good. Adam Blazek ties it up.
Big shot by Adam Blazek. Now is the question, is this going to be the time when Blazek lights up the scoreboard? We've been hinting at it all game long. He's due. He's a senior, or junior, I beg your pardon, to compete. Or is he a senior? Yeah, he's a senior. Thank you for the confirmation, Zach. Senior competing in his first PSAC championship game on his last home game. It's his time.
Chance for three. It's good, and the players of the year, maybe they're starting to go at it. Three-point game again for IUP, 4:15 to go. Blazek feeds it over to Dogan. Porter to Blazek in the corner. Blazek for another three. No good, just rims out. If he hit that, Hammermill's crowd might have exploded, Cody.
It would have been close to it either way. We're just under 4 minutes left now. IUP still clinging on to that three-point lead.
Chance going to slow it down. 22 to work with for the Hawks. Norfleet. Now to Chance after going to Jeffers. Norfleet was looking at Jeffers in the corner, but there was a little bit of traffic in front of him. Six to shoot. Chance. trying to work in. His layup is good. Devontae Chance with five straight for the Crimson Hawks.
Now it's a two-possession game with 3.5 left. Timeout, Gannon.
And that will not be the media. We will keep it right here. But Gannon and Coach Riley with 3:27 to go. I honestly thought, Cody, when Adam Blazek hit that big three, that Gannon was going to start another run that they do. But Devontae Chance, this year's Athlete of the Year in the West, is showing otherwise.
Yeah, and if you just joined us, Zach, there's been a lot that you've missed. A complete offensive showdown here between the Crimson Hawks of Indiana University of Pennsylvania and the Golden Knights of Gannon University. 66-61, a combined 127 points between these two squads with 3.5 minutes left to go. You're just seeing a few of the shots that were made here during the last sequence of events. Devontae Chance lighting up the board along with Adam Blazek, who's finally starting to turn it up. We expected Blazek to maybe be more of a threat, but he's well known for getting those shots off in the second half and carrying Gannon on those runs, just like you said, with the clock winding down. But now it's become a mano a mano battle between him and Chance, literally, and the rest of their squads.
And I would not expect any other player for either of these teams to get the ball in the last few minutes of this game. Players of the Year in their own right. Been here for 4 years, both of their squads, the senior captains, leaders, and Blazek, his final home game. I'm sure he won't want to go out on a sour note. Blazek now with the ball, trying to drive in. Guarded by Chance, feeds it down low to Porter. Porter back to the basket against Cottrell. His layup is good and one.
Porter on that one, showing fantastic patience, waiting for his opportunity.
And that will bring us to our final media timeout. 3:04 to go. We're not done yet. Gannon trying to hold in there. Stay tuned for the final few minutes on PCN.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride in our efforts in the arena and in the classroom. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference. Passion, pride, Pennsylvania.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to make a wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
And we are back here on PCN. Adarius Porter going to the line, trying to convert an and one. That last foul went on Devon Cottrell. That's his fourth. And 3:04 left, Cody. It's building to an exciting finish.
Definitely promising to be a nail biter all the way down to the end. I don't think the lead has been greater than 5 points for a really long time for either of these teams.
Porter at the line. Free throw. No good, rebounded by Ugbede, and it stays a three-point game with 3 minutes even to go. Chance, he has 22, tied with Dyer and Smith for the most in this contest. Taking his time, 15 to work with and 2:42 to go. Guarded by Blazek, Chance has it again. Trying to cross up Blazek, he's going in, steps back, and that's gonna be a 5 second call against Devontae Chance. A costly turnover there for the senior guard.
And that's a huge turnover because now Gannon gets the chance to make this a very clear one possession game or tie it up. 66-63. They're down by three. Capitalizing on turnovers is key. Let's see if the Golden Knights can do it here.
And you got to think Adam Blazek is going to get the ball in this possession. He has it now. Brought it by Dyer. He feeds it over to Toupain. And then Smith, who has a high 22 for Gannon. His layup. Good! And one coming. Oh, my goodness. What a play by Jabron Smith, Cody.
Jabron Smith last game lit up the scoreboard for the Golden Knights. And now he's starting to do it again here when it really counts. 66-65. Look at this replay. Down the right post. Taking the leap at the right block and jumping up for the shot, getting it in there, and one coming.
And it looks like this might be a timeout taken by IUP. Devon Cottrell has just fouled out in this game as well. He has five, so we'll see who comes in for him. And Cody, that shot was something else. He was leaning away from it after being fouled, and he still was able to hook it into the basket. We'll look at it in a second. 2:20 to go, and Jabron Smith, his first 2 points of this half after having 22 in the first.
Yeah, all of his momentum was carrying towards his right side while the basket was on his left after getting bumped into by Cottrell. And whenever you're flying backwards, it's really tough to throw the ball up there and get the shot made.
And this series for Gannon was all started because of a 5-second violation by Chance. Free throw is no good. Out of bounds off of Gannon. And it's going to be IUP ball. That's a costly miss for Smith.
And it looked like no one wanted to touch it when it was going out of bounds.
Yeah, Norfleet was there watching the ball go out. 2:12 to go. This one's winding down to the end. Really won't know who's probably going to be, you know, the victor, of course, until Triple Zero's, but you may not know clearly who might be until the end as well. Jeffers, corner three, no good. Rebounded by Jabron Smith.
Jabron Smith jumping up like he was on the moon leaping for that one. Huge defensive rebound.
Blazek to Smith. 1:46 to go. Tipped out of bounds off of IUP. That's Jeremy Jeffers down low working against Thomas Edwards.
Jeffers playing the aggressive defense, trying to swat the pass away, and it went out of bounds. It forces Gannon to inbound from the near corner.
66-65 the score. A minute 45 to go. 23 to work with for Gannon. Blazek, he's going to inbound it. Throws it to Jabron Smith. Saves it from going out of bounds. And he brings it back across half court. Smith to Blazek. And he will be fouled by Brandon Norfleet. He will go to the line for a 1-1 as IUP only has, actually no, this will be a double bonus as the scoreboard updates. Blazek at the line trying to get Gannon the lead.
He could get the lead or he could tie it up. Either way, Blazek, right before he went for that shot, it was the foul. So the foul was on the floor, but because of the double bonus, it's going to be a shooting foul now. 95 seconds left to go in the game. Gannon trailing by one, pending these free throws.
And Blazek misses the first. Clutch moment escapes the senior. A minute 35 left. Gannon can still tie it if Blazek makes the shot.
Blazek so far on the day 5-for-6, so make it 5-for-7 pending this next one.
Second is good as it rattles home. 135, all tied up at 66. And IUP will call a timeout as Chance gets it across half court. Cody, if you're Coach Lombardi, what do you tell your team? I actually spoke with him yesterday, and he said, you know, sometimes Devontae Chance leads this huddle. I think right now you need that coaching experience in there.
Yeah, if you're Coach Lombardi, what you would be telling your players right now is you are capable of pulling away with this victory. You've shown it all year long, getting these key shots whenever they were pretty important, with the long threes by Devontae Chance or fighting underneath on the baseline or from one of the blocks down the post. Get the opportunities and take advantage of them. Don't fall back on defense either, like they may have done in the first half. We saw a couple wide open jumpers from Gannon in the first half because the defense was pulling back a little bit. Because now, if you foul, that's going to send your opponent to the free throw line. Either way, both teams have more than 10 team fouls right now. So play clean basketball while playing aggressive at the same time. It's tough, but it can be done.
Chance gets the inbound. 30 seconds on the shot clock. A minute 28 to go. If IUP holds it, they can wind it down to less than a minute. Dyer driving the baseline. His layup, no good. Johnny's Toupin comes away with the ball and feeds it back to Adam Blazek. A minute 15 to go. Blazek circling around the defense. Gets a screen from Porter. Throws it over. Almost lost by Smith. He was looking at the shot before the ball. Now he takes the three. It's no good. Offensive rebound by Johnny's Toupin with a minute to go, Cody.
Toupin saw that from the very beginning. He knew it was going to hit off the front and just ran or strafed himself along the basket waiting for it to come to him.
Porter to Toupin. Blazek, 4-3, top of the key. No good. Rims out. Up and it's rebounded by Ugbede. Chance going to bring it up. 38 seconds left in the game. IUP cannot hold for final possession.
But now's when things get interesting because time management becomes an important strategy. Timeout, IUP.
And this one coming down to the final possession for both teams.
All tied up at 66. 32 seconds left.
Basically, because it's really 31.9, but it's basically 32 seconds left, and there's 25 on the shot clock for IUP, so it's about a 7 second difference. And Cody, that last series for Gannon, they had a couple clean open looks for three, they just weren't able to put them in, and IUP has been shooting pretty well in this half. Gannon's defense has to make a stand here, I think, because IUP, I believe, is in firm control right now. They could waste a lot of time and then go for the shot here.
Yeah, IUP had a 15% increase for shooting from free throws, 62.5 compared to 77.3. From the floor, their shooting percentage actually has gone down since the first half, but not by much, only 4%.
Chance gets the inbound, guarded by Adam Blazek. Like you said, a mano-a-mano matchup right now. Chance trying to drive in. Now he's double-teamed by Thomas Edwards and Blazek. Thomas Edwards falls off. Screen from Ugbede. He loses the ball. It's on the ground. Jump ball possession. Gannon with 15.2 left, Cody. Gannon can hold for the final shot.
This is it. I won't be surprised if Gannon calls a timeout here. 15.2 seconds left. The shot clock is going to turn off. Gannon has last shot here, unless IUP takes it away.
And Gannon has just called timeout. Adarius Porter goes to the ref and signals, I want a timeout. Cody, if you're Coach Riley, what do you do? I'll give my straight answer. Give the ball to Adam Blazek. It's his time.
It's his time.
His jersey may be hanging up in these halls one day. Give it to him. What would you do?
Well, what we might want to do here, if you're Gannon, is just not force anything. And he was the one that created this strip here and forced the jump ball. Literally, he saw it on the ground, just dove for it, just completely in midair. Because he knew the possession arrow favored Gannon. And so getting the ball back is pivotal here. If Blazek gets it, do not force anything. You are not losing. You don't need to force anything. With the 66-66 score, wait for your opportunity. Believe me, you'll see it when it comes to you. Wait for it, whether with it's a clean pass or taking the jumper for yourself. Let the crowd be in your favor. Believe me, Gannon's at home. They love their home crowd as much as the fans love their team. As you hear the GU chant coming from them right now, just wait for your opportunity and take it.
And honestly, Cody, that GU chant, at first thought, I thought it was saying believe, which you could say here as well.
Now, both of them apply here.
If you're IEP, it's a radical thought, I know, but could you foul and at least give yourself the last shot here?
But if they foul and then make the two shots, you put the pressure on yourself. That's the problem with having 10 team fouls for both teams. If you foul, you send a free throw shooter to the line with the potential to take the lead and put the pressure that you need to force something. That's the problem there.
The Gannon fans are all on their feet. Adam Blazek gets the inbounds pass with 13 seconds to go in the PSAC Men's Championship. Blazek with it. Got it by Norfleet. Blazek in the corner. Smith. Smith takes a three. It's good. 2.4 seconds left. IUP going to inbound the ball. Norfleet has it. And there's going to be a timeout called by IUP with 2.4 seconds left. And Gannon is that close to winning their first championship and since 2009.
I don't know about you, Zach, but I felt the ground shake as soon as that shot drained through. Nothing but net. Look at this shot. That's the shot of the game right there. If you're the Golden Knights and you can hang on to this 3-point lead with 2.4 seconds left. Coach Lombardi, needs to draw up a quick plan, literally a quick plan, to get the ball down the court and throw a desperation shot, hope it goes in. That's all you can do right now if you're the Crimson Hawks, because this is the pressure that I was talking about before. If you had the had the deficit, then you got to force things. And usually forcing things does not happen.
And this one will go down as one of the greatest shots in Gannon history. Jabron Smith now with 27 points in this contest. Only 5 this half, Cody. But man, were those 3 right there ever so important? The other idea for Gannon playing defense, you could foul here because that's only 2 shots and force IUP to miss one. And sometimes it's harder to miss a free throw intentionally than make it. So it comes into question, what do you do? I think you have to play, let them go. If they make the shot, fine, we'll play you for 5 more minutes. But IUP, you gotta draw something up that could give you a chance to play for those extra few moments. And of course, if you're Gannon, if you see somebody shoot the ball, run away from them, don't foul them.
Exactly, let them take their chance. Let them take the risk, because if you foul, they make one, they can throw, I've only seen this happen a handful of times before. They can throw it off the backboard, get the shot, make the 3-point and win. It's rare, but it can happen. So I agree with you, Zach. Just fall back, take control, complete control of the court, and here we go.
And Gannon's gonna take a timeout after they look at the set IEP was coming out with on offense. So we'll have a few more minutes, Cody. And if we only have a couple more seconds, we wanna thank again our partners of PCN for being able to broadcast this game today.
Yeah, and special shout out to anyone that may be watching on the PCN Select app. You can watch PCN Sports and all of PCN's original content on the go anytime, anywhere with PCN Select, available online or on the PCN Select app. Watch the network live or enjoy new selected video on demand. And trust me, if you don't want to watch this game again, then that would be really surprising, because I have been a part of California University Television for 3 years. This is one of the greatest games I have ever seen. Yes. PSAC championship with that magnitude.
Seems like every time we're at Gannon for PSAC tournament play, it goes down to the wire. Overtime, then double overtime, and then right now, 2.4 seconds left. It'll be Cornell Yard to inbound it for IUP. Jeffers, Chance, Dyer, and Hanner out on the court. It's inbounded. Hanner loses it to Adam Blazek, and Gannon are the PSAC champions. And who else better to end up with the ball than Adam Blazek?
For the first time since 2009, the PSAC championship crown comes to the Hammer Mill Center in Gannon University. Congratulations to the Golden Knights.
And before we get into the celebration for Gannon, we will take a short break. Gannon winners 69-66 on a last second shot from Jabron Smith.
NCAA Division II has much to cheer about, as nearly 100,000 student athletes compete with passion and pride. And I'm pleased to share the best news of all. Student athletes are outperforming the rest of the D2 student body in graduation rates. Just another reason why you'll hear us say with pride, I chose Division II. Learn more at d2sa.org.
With 18 institutions, my conference is the largest league across all NCAA classifications. With nearly 7,000 student athletes competing in 23 championships, my conference sponsors the most championships in Division II. With a 78% academic success rate, my conference graduates student athletes well above the national average. We compete with passion. We take pride.
And welcome back in to the Hammer Mill Center. Gannon, 69-66 winners over IUP. And Cody, this was an instant classic all the way down to the end.
Might be one of those ones that we might be digging up from the vault sometime in the near future. You're going to take one more look at the shot that ended it all. A 3-point shot from downtown. Nothing but net, giving Gannon the 69-66 lead, and that ended up being the final score because the clock stopped with 2.4 seconds left, and that's all that they needed to kill off.
You see Adam Blazek right there He didn't get that winning basket, but he ended up with the ball in his hands at the last moment, and nothing seems more fitting for Gannon than to have that happen. We are going to have the trophy presentation in a moment, and Cody, we already know the MVP of this game goes to Jabron Smith. He had 10 points, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists against Kutztown and against IUP. He had 27, 5 rebounds, and an assist. That's an average of 18.5 a game, 4 rebounds, and a 1.5 assist.
Jabron Smith scored the points and made the points happen. We saw he was one of 3 Gannon shooters to go into double digits against Kutztown, and he just went to town against IUP, getting the 27 points, like you said, Zach.
And it looks like IUP has accepted their trophy as runners-up in the men's basketball championship, taking it back to the locker room. And you know, Cody, you cannot hold your head low if you're IUP. They had a great run. They were struggling at some points this year, and it seems everything came together for them. They are definitely probably going to make the Atlantic Region Tournament, but Gannon has secured their spot towards the top so far.
They have, with the PSAC crown coming to the Western Conference. We knew it was going to come to the Western Conference whenever we saw that Gannon was going to be taking on IUP in the final round. They secured their spot in the big dance that's coming up sometime next week. It will be starting with this victory here. Big victory on both of those magnitudes.
And we're seeing each of the individual player awards. Now, Daniel Kegler getting his. We saw him earlier in this game. William Gadsden, number 4, who's actually the brother of Riot Gadsden, who actually used to play at California. And now, none bigger right now than Adam Blazek. Look at the crowd. Hear them roar for Adam Blazek, his final home game, most likely.
He gets to walk away with a PSAC championship.
Corey Bailey getting his. And a couple other Gannon Golden Knights coming out. A couple of the redshirt players as well. Matthew Dogan and Cody. Gannon has fought very long and hard to be able to get to this stage. It's been since 2009, and they did not join the conference until about 7 years ago. And they were one of the top teams already coming in. Although they're young in this conference, they are definitely building a name for themselves.
Yeah, they're relatively new in the conference, just like you said, Zach. And this is they have a huge athletic history. Over on the far wall in front of us, you see banners all the way across from end to end, from the 60s all the way to the late 2000s. And now they can add another one up there, 2015 PSAC champions, right next to that 2009 one.
Yeah, there is a little space ready for it. And also in 2009, they were in the Elite Eight and they were Atlantic Region champions, looking to do that as well. Because the mantra always goes, you don't have one more to play in the PSAC, but you have at least a lot more that you want to play in the NCAAs. We see now the assistant coaches getting their awards. And John Riley, not a coach probably more deserving. This year he became Gannon's all-time winningest coach with 180 wins. He actually got that mark against California in our game. And he gets his award right here. And I talked to him yesterday. A great guy, very personable character. And he coaches these gentlemen to success like you've seen today.
Yeah, and it was evident here on the court. They buckled down under pressure, getting that opportunity to fall through whenever they needed it. Just like I kept saying before, wait for your opportunity to come and seize the moment.
And the MVP award is now being awarded. As we said before, it is going to Jabron Smith. And hearing his totals over the overhead announcer, 37 points, 8 rebounds, and 3 assists in 2 games. Jabron Smith being named MVP of the Final Four.
Just listen to that crowd, Zach. That's a beautiful crowd.
I'll say this. It's kind of like myself being a Steelers fan and Santonio Holmes. Although he doesn't play for them anymore, there's always going to be a special place in my heart for what he did in Super Bowl 43. And the Gannon fans here today will always have a special place in their memories knowing Jabron Smith hit that shot to make them PSAC champions, as now they hold up the banner and are receiving the trophy. We'll see who grabs the trophy first. That's always one of the traditions. Who gets it first? I think you would have to give it to Adam Blazek. Looks like they're giving it just to the team. They're all putting their hands on it. You see right there, Adam Blazek front and center, Jabron Smith, Thomas Edwards, a couple of the seniors. A great season for the Gannon Golden Knights.
That three-point shot is going to go down as one of the greatest shots in Gannon history.
And here's like some of the highlights from this game, Cody. It was an instant classic all around.
Fantastic offensive performance by both of these teams here today. 135 combined total points in this game, both by Gannon and IUP, getting it done, driving down the lanes, and taking the long jumpers. During the first half, we saw most of the time the long jump shots being made, and Gannon wasn't making too many of them, but then they were able to find the lanes and take advantage of the posts and jumping on the blocks, getting the hook shots up, getting the layups up, and IUP continued to dominate from beyond the three-point arc. That's been their story. And this shot right there, Jabron Smith, look at that crowd behind there. The crowd on the right side throwing their arms up in the air in excitement. That's a beautiful sight to see. Jabron Smith giving the PSAC crown to Gannon with that shot.
And tonight at 10:30, Gannon will be waiting to see where, when, and who they'll play in the NCAA Atlantic Regional. Thank you for watching PCN's coverage of the PSAC Men's Basketball Championship from CU TV. For every one of our crew, Cody Jeanette, I'm Zach Prosma. Thank you for watching. And of course, have a good night, everybody.